morning. My name is Amalina. I'm one of the doctors here. So I've been told that you've been having some pain on your tummy, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
How long has that been going on for?
For about a couple of days.
Okay.
It's getting worse and worse.
I'm very sorry. So where did it exactly start, the pain?
Kind of started everywhere, maybe like in the middle. Now it's gone to the right side and it really hurts.
Right, okay. Have you been having any temperature at all?
No, not really. I maybe had some chills, but not really.
Okay. Have you been vomiting?
No, but I feel really sick.
Okay. And do you have any other problems at all?
No, otherwise I'm fit and well.
Okay. And when was the last time that you had your period?
About like 3 weeks ago.
2 weeks ago, okay. And you're not any contraceptive methods at all?
No.
No. And you're not expecting that you're pregnant at the moment?
No, I'm not in any relationship.
Okay, that's fine. We can do a little bit of tests. So I'm just going to do some examination. Would that be okay?
Yeah.
Can you just lie down for me? So the patient is talking to me, her airway is patent. So I'm just going to do some examinations. So I'm just going to have a listen to your chest, okay?
Okay.
Ideally, I'll do it from the back. Will you be able to sit upright for me?
Yeah.
Just take a deep breath in and out. And I'm going to ask the nurse to do her saturation level and also measure her respiratory rate. Her respiratory rate at the moment is about 16, so I'm going to proceed with C. So I'm just going to have a look at her hands. Hands are a little bit cold and a bit clammy. Her cap wave feels about 3 to 4 seconds peripherally and centrally. About 3 to 4 seconds. So I'm going to ask the nurse to do blood pressure measurements and also put white ball cannulas on both of her arms and take some blood, the FBC, UNEs, CRB, group and safe, and also do a venous gas to find her lactate. So I'm going to do a physical examination. I'm also going to ask the nurse to give, because her blood pressure is a little bit low, she's a little bit hypotensive. Her blood pressure is 90 over 60 and her heart rate is about 110. So I'm going to give her a start 1 liter of sodium chloride solution to try to maintain her blood pressure within normal range. So I'm just going to move on to examining her abdomen. Have you got any pain at the moment at all? No. So I'm going to start off away from the pain and gently. So she is standing on the right eyelid fossa, and I'm going to do rebound tenderness. So that is a positive rebound tenderness test. I'm going to push on the left hand side. Do you feel any pain at all in that?
No.
Can you feel any pain on the right hand side when I do that?
No.
Okay. And I'm going to check her groins. And give me a cough. Okay. And any tenderness at all down here?
Okay.
Right. So I'm going to move forward. And so she's standing on the right left fossa, but her abdomen is soft. She's got rebound tenderness. So I'm going to proceed with exposing her other parts of the body and also examining her calves and other areas to find out if there's any other problems, issues. So I'm going to move to D. So her GCS is 15, she's obeying command, she is talking to me and she's not confused. I'm also going to ask the nurse to check her blood sugar levels, her BM is normal, and I'm also going to check her pupils and is equal and reactive. So further investigations that I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to check for her urine dip and also do a beta HCG test to find out if she's pregnant or not. One of the differential diagnoses that we need to exclude is ectopic pregnancy in women, the young woman with childbearing age. I will also arrange for her to have an ultrasound scan to rule out any evidence of any ovarian pathology, because one of the things that we need to rule out is a possible ovarian torsion or ruptured ovarian cyst for a woman at her age. Obviously, the top differential diagnosis for this scenario is an acute appendicitis. So I'm going to reassess how she is doing. So after giving her the fluids, now her blood pressure has come back within a normal range. She's not tachycardic anymore, and she had a temperature of 37.9 initially, but I'm going to give her some IV paracetamol to try to bring it down. And also, I think the top differential diagnosis for this case is an acute appendicitis. So therefore, I'm going to speak to my seniors and discuss about the case, and I'm going to speak to the anaesthetist about the possibility of taking her to theatre for laparoscopic appendicectomy, and I'm going to consent her for the surgery. I'm going to make sure that a recruitment safe is sent out, and I'm going to book the theatre for a slot in theatre, and making sure everything else is sorted. I'm also going to start her with intravenous antibiotics and check for her allergies as well to make sure that she's not allergic to those antibiotics. I'll also explain to her about what's going to happen. So I'm just going to let you know that the possibility is that you might have appendicitis, which means that your appendix might be inflamed. And so that's the reason why you might be having this problem with the pain on your tummy and also probably a little bit of temperature. But obviously you need to do some further investigations with the scan initially in the first instance to make sure that there is no other issues going on, because you also, there is a possibility that there might be to do with your ovaries. And from the urine dip test that we did, there is no evidence of urine infection or of you being pregnant. So we can rule out the fact that you don't have problem with ectopic pregnancy, which is pregnancy outside of your womb. So now we're going to take you to the radiology department for you to have your scan done. And then once that's done, and then we can make a decision about what the next plan for us to do in terms of management plan. But you are in safe hands. We're going to give you antibiotics and painkillers for you. If there is any problem or any issues, the nurses will call me